Hey, beautiful people, loungers, comment allez-vous? Comment allez-vous ce soir ou cet après-midi, tout dépendant quand vous verrez ce vlog sur Agile Lounge à agilelounge.com. Voilà, c'est un wrap-up de cet autre magnifique moment à Manhattan, à New York, donc sur l'île de Manhattan, la presqu'île de Manhattan. Donc aujourd'hui, c'était samedi le 16 mars et j'ai passé une excellente journée à ne rien faire d'autre que de marcher, que de me promener en autobus avec des guides complètement hilarants. On s'est fait du fun, on a ri et j'ai encore passé pour un local avec ces guides. Ils pensaient que j'étais un smart ass of Brooklyn ou New York encore. It's always amazing when that happens. So apparently, yes, I have the face, the funny slang slide, and everything about a New Yorker. I'm a 212, but in fact, I'm a 514. So I had a lot of 212 moments today. One of the funny moments we had was into that kind of bus tour that I just picked it up out of Battery Park, because Battery Park is one of my favorite place to hang out and see the sunset or the Liberty Statue from afar. And this is there, yeah, you could also take on the east side, on the East River, not the Hudson, but on the east side. There's two ferries, actually. If you come in New York, don't pay to take the ferry, guys. Don't pay to go to Ellis Island. It's too crowded anyway, and so it's not worth it anymore because it's too many people. So my suggestion to you as a part-time New Yorker now is to take the New Jersey ferry or the Staten Island ferry. And you do it like back and forth, and that's it. And you know why? Because these are regular transportation, so it's not necessarily touristic. And what? Whether, especially for the New Jersey one, whether you have or not a slip ticket from the MTA or the subway, it's gonna be free. It's free for everyone. Yes. So don't be fooled. So then you go around the bay, you pass through the Statue of Liberty, you take nice picture and stuff, and it was free. And then if you go to New Jersey, there's a couple of nice restaurants, especially in the summer with seafood, if you like seafood like me. And yes, that's it. So voilà. Yes, as you could see behind me, it's the southeast of Manhattan. So we are at Hell's Kitchen here on 57th Street. This is where I had my room, and behind me it's an hotel. I don't remember if it's the Sheraton, this one with the pyramid, but anyway. So yes, I just wrap him up right this. It's just a free vlog. It won't be an Agility Gaga series. Maybe not yet. I might do another one about this for thought about the Business Agility Summit and so on. So yeah, truly, I made a lot of new friends, new connection here, in Manhattan in this last 3 4 days. So I get my foot with Barclay. Instead of going into London with them, I could make some difference here in Manhattan, and maybe after we'll see for Europe. But we'll start by some advising them a weeks and so about a month ago. And I met also a team that was working for my guys in Austin, Yex. And they liked it, so I'm gonna be their on-demand coach for both of them. Barclay, more enterprise coach with the C-suite, the C-level people that they have here, to start them thinking about like how they could bring the European transformation of agility here in New York. And the other amazing thing that's with TX is on top of putting bridge between a supplier to my other client. As my other client, I'm going down and phasing out after 2.5 years. I think we should use more of five of their 35 Scrum Master leveraging as coach and enterprise coach. I think they will be ready for that. So they will need me less. So, and the guys here actually hire me more as a customer experience CX UX advisor with agility and Scrum coaching because they like what happened in Austin, and we might like kind of making bridge. And I just discovered that EX has office in Montreal. I didn't know that. So I might also not always coming here. I will be able to do some work sometimes from a Montreal office. So I will have to discover that. But of course, I like to come in Manhattan. And if it were not for family matter or other stuff, I think I could easily immigrate here. And yeah, basically that's it. So that was the thing on Agile Lounge expanding worldwide. Great meeting with Sue Ryu. Sue, I salute you. That we had at the Breather on 43rd Street. It was very nice to meet and do a Y session workshop about Enterprise Scrum and the future of Enterprise Scrum. How we're going to make Mike Beadle's idea and framework and way of working for scaling business agility throughout any organization of any size for a smarter and better future. So I think we had our base of how we're going to work together, and we have a 2019 plan on how to make it into practice, make it alive. And then we'll see if we could like spread this with other agilists, other business agility people mindset, not conventional agiler. It will not work with us. We don't work with conventional people. We don't work with people who just brag about agile and lean. We want people who actually have experience and transformation and scientific kind of mindset also to be able to do subsension and of course continuous improvement. So we work with open mind people and professional that could bring something more. So we'll see. But I'm really, really optimistic about the future, what the future holds in terms of developing new ways. So that is for Agile Lounge, the brand and the company that I'm building in the last 2.5 years. That is actually the one of the pillar, because I'm going to have 3 pillars. The pillar of Enterprise Scrum that I'm going to pursue the not the legacy in term of I have to be really careful in English with that term. What I mean is we'll pursue the work and thinking of Mike Beadle because we see value into it, and this is amazing. So this is one pillar, and Sue will be my partner into this. The second pillar is, and we'll see when I'm coming back in Montreal, I would like to bridge the mindset, the concept, and the idea of conscious leadership, conscious capitalisms with business agility. So I need a talk for that, but this is one pillar that I would like to observe. For some of you, you saw in the intro video that I'm already putting those words as pillar because I think it's important for me, not just being one thing as agile coach. That means more and more nothing in the world of con artists. And the third pillar will be with Kurt Mercadante, if I could bridge with him or receive teaching from him. I think the freedom mindset lifestyle, it's a true thing. It's really vibrating with me. It's really connecting with me. And I would like to explore this to actually catalyze and coach entrepreneur and startup people. And anyone actually out there that would like to receive some kind of advice, some kind of coaching in a sense of spark into your life, to make your life better, to make your life truthful, to make your life with a purpose, to find your why, your personal why. This is also your professional why, because as Kurt and myself believe, there's no such thing. It's totally bullshit to think of work and life balance. We are an entire body, an entire person, a whole person that is actually experiencing and living and working all together. So the freedom mindset is this. So it's something that I'd like to explore because I think there's a need sometimes to spark someone. So this type of coaching that I'm going to offer for 2019 and moving on 2020 will not be like a permanent coaching. It will be actually a couple of sessions, and then you should be autonomous and go by yourself because you should be independent in any type of coaching, actually. This is why I don't think anymore I will have long-term type of contract unless it's a really strong transformation program process for a very large-scale organization. Like maybe that will happen because right now Barclay will be time-to-time helping them to identify the opportunity and all the model of England will be implementing here and the branch of New York or the things. So this, you see, that a couple of times, the people from the inside who was permanently there could catch up and continue. So this is the thing. As a coach, I'd like to enable you. I'd like to start you up, and then you're free as a bird for the three things that I'm talking about. So Freedom Club, Business Agility, and Enterprise Scrum, or I should say Enterprise Scrum for business agility. And of course, we'll see if I will create something, a new concept about the ideas that I have in my mind about like conscious agility to bridge with Dr. Barrett and Stéphane Leblanc type of work and leadership. But definitely more and more I mentor and coach C-level, C-executive people. This is my highest motivation. So this is why I might pursue my CEC with Scrum Alliance for Certified Enterprise Coaching. But this, again, it's going to be a refinement of my value list for the next year, if I continue or not with Scrum Alliance, or if I concentrate on, instead of getting certification, maybe reaching out for knowledge. And if this knowledge required to pass a type of exam to be certified, but we might do that game. But again, I don't think like to be a freedom fighter, freedom clubber, or an agile launcher or a conscious leadership. You just need to know yourself and to actually practice what you preach, make it like a quick win, make it an action, and make people happier. So Agile Launch is signing off. Thank you guys for listening. Like this video, share, subscribe to my channel, spread the love, spread the agile consciousness, and see you soon. Goodbye.